Assalamu alaikum students, moving forward in our continuous random variable chapter number 3 of statistics 2 lectures. Now we are going to discuss the concept of variance, okay? That how do you find the variance in this chapter? So let's say concept number 3 and we are finding the variance, okay? So how do you find the variance? Again, we take help from a past paper question to understand the concept of variance. It's going to be the probability density function of a random variable x is given by fx 0 otherwise, and this is the function. So it's where 0 till 6 is the interval. So from between 0 and 6 we will have the probability as 1 under the graph. Probability under the graph will be 1 while remaining will be 0, okay? So where k is a constant, so the first thing will be, again, always remember in this chapter, if you are getting an unknown constant, you will have to find that as well, okay? Doesn't matter whatever the question is. So for 6 marks we are being tested that where k is a constant, you have to state the value of e mean and you have to show that the variance is 9/5, okay? So you have to state the value of mean and show that. So the answer is also in front of us, but let's understand the concept, okay? So first thing, let's just do simply how firstly find out the value of k, because you already know that it will, k will come outside and you are going to integrate 6x minus x square from 0 limit to the upper limit of 6, okay? The limits will be, let's do it in the other color, 0 and 6. And you will, this will be dx, okay? And you will it yourself say that the probability, total probability, sir, is 1, okay, students? So here we go. Let's do this on one side of the page, okay? Hope everyone gets this, that we already know that from 0 till 6, the total probability will be 1. So we can easily find out the value of k using this tactic, okay? So you start integrating, so k is outside. And when I start integrating, I will be getting 6x square divided by 2 minus x cube divided by 3 for the limits of 0 and 6 is equals to 1, okay? So I have done the integration, students. 2 ones are, 2 threes are. Let's just simplify it further, okay? So it is going to be, sir, k times, k is outside, 3x square minus x cube divided by 3 as the integration, sir. And you are going to say the limits are 0 till 6 is equals to 1. So let's first put the limit of 6 there and then the 0. So here we go, sir, k times of, we say that it will be 6 square 36. 36 is times 3. Make sure you have calculator, students. Hope everyone is getting the concept, okay? The concept should be clear that I am using the limits intervals of 0 to 6 to find out the value of k. 6 cube will be 216, right? So it will be 108 minus 2163. That is what I get the value when I put the value of k there. And when you put the value of 0, you will get 0 only. So we are left with only this thing, okay? Minus 0. So 108 minus 216 divided by 3. So let's do 108 minus 216 divided by 3. I am going to get, students, the answer as 36k. And then the value of k will be 1/36, okay? Hope everyone gets this. This is basically 2 marks you will get to get the working of k over 136, okay? So you will get 2 marks if you get the constant value, that is 1/36, okay? That is important for the other part of the question. Next, you need to understand that there is another concept that you need to learn, students, in this question. How do you state the value of mean, okay? You don't have to calculate. If you calculate the value of mean as from the previous concepts, how do we find mean? Generally, we understand, students, that, sir, generally we find mean by multiplication of the function, right? You multiply the x with the function, right? And then you integrate that, okay? You are going to multiply the x with the function and integrate it from the limits given, that is a to b limits. That is the normal general function of mean, right? That multiply the function with x and then integrate from the limits for a to b. But in this case, you are not going to apply that tactic. And sometimes whenever the word of state is being used, you will have to understand that you will have to use the equation, okay? You will have to use the probability density function. So follow carefully. If you understand that, let's say k is 1/36 and I'll take it outside. So if you understand that, you are left with 6x minus x square, okay? And you can still take it outside, okay? You can still take x outside, so you'll be left with 6 minus x, okay? You'll be left inside with 6x minus 6. So it's basically a quadratic equation, students, that we need to understand. It's basically a quadratic equation because when x is 0, or when y is 0, you are going to get the two answers, okay? So students need to understand, it's basically that it will be 0 and 6, okay? So 0 is one answer and 6 is one answer. When x is 0 and when x is 6, y is 0, okay? When x is 0, y is 0. When x is 6, y is 0. So the graph is going to be something looking like this for this, okay? The graph is going to be something looking like this. Hope students are getting this. And in this type of quadratic graph, because the area under the curve is 1, so you can say that the mean is basically the average. So average is going to be 3, okay? So you can directly write the average is the midpoint of 0 and 6. So I can give you the answer here that it will be 3, the mean. And otherwise, you can solve it on a pencil. What is the mean? Okay, you can work it out. So it's very important to understand that the mean is going to be 3 here. And let me explain the concept again. It is basically because of the quadratic equation. Mean is the average, and it's under the graph. The curve will be, the probability will be, and the area will be students 1. And that is why you can judge directly the value of EX will be 1, okay? Next, we have to show that the variance of what is the variance of X, okay? So understand now. So you got 2 marks for the finding out the value of K, 1 mark for getting the mean correct. So 3 marks here, and 3 marks are for the variance. So understand the concept of variance, students, as well from this recent paper of 2021 topical past paper questions. Students need to understand that variance, when you are finding the variance, it's basically the integration you have to do. But before that, you multiply x square with the probability density function for the given interval a and b. Whatever the given interval is, a and b, you are going to multiply x square with the probability density function, integrate that, and subtract the mean square, okay? You are going to subtract the mean square. So that is the formula, students, okay? That is the formula that you have to subtract the mean square as well, okay? Hope everyone gets this. So now we are going to work for how we are going to find the variance, okay? So let's say that we take 1 over 36 going to be definitely outside. And first you are going to multiply x square with 6x minus x square, okay? Let's do this first, okay? And without putting the limits, or because first thing is, how do you solve 1 over 36 into 6x cube? This will become 6x cube, and this will become x power 4, okay? 6x cube minus x power 4, that is what you are going to integrate now, students. Make sure, follow carefully, the limits are 0 till 6, sir. The limits remains the same, a and b, 0 till 6, okay? K is the constant value, I've taken it outside. Make sure integration concepts of P3 are clear. Hope everyone is getting this lecture. Very important to understand, students, that we have 1 over, for variance, we have to square x square multiplied by the density function, okay? So this is the first step, okay? So let's take out the integration, 6x power 4 divided by 4 minus x power 5 divided by 5. Here we go. This is 0 till 6, the limits, okay? And k is there as well, okay? So let's first work it out, whatever the answer is. When we put 0, we get nothing. Like when we put 0, it's 0. So let's just put the 6 there only. 6 power 4 divided by 4 minus 6 power 5 divided by 5. Let's see what this answer is coming. So make sure you have a calculator, 6 into 6 power 4. And we got this 4 minus 6 power 5 divided by 5, and I'm getting it as 1944. So 1 over 36, that is the k value, multiply by 1944 over 5, okay, students? So, and minus 0 is nothing, so this we got. So it will be 1 over 36, and I'm getting 54 over 5, okay? So this is one value, 54 over 5, because we have to prove variance is 9 over 5. Follow carefully. This is half part done, okay? At the moment, I have done, students, this part only, that x square multiply by the probability density function, then integration done, simplified, everything done, algebraic expression, we got it, 54 divided by 5. Now I'm going to minus the mean, okay? So mean is 3, so 3 square you minus, that is 9, okay? So 54 divided by 5 minus 9 is basically 9 over 5, or you can say 1.8. And this is what we say, that we have proved it, okay? Make sure this step is very important. I'm highlighting in the green color. The 3 square, you have to subtract the mean square, okay? Mean is 3, so 3 square will be 9. And that's what I've done. And I got the variance as 9 over 5, students. And here it is proved. Okay, 9/5 or 1.8. You have to tell the examiner that you have proved and you got all remaining 3 marks for here. Okay, so this is how you solve for 6 marks, one of the recent questions. Hope everyone got the concept of variance. A lot of students forgot to square the mean square. Okay, a lot of students forget to do this part, the mean square. So make sure you don't do that. And as I said, it's all the formula chapter related. So that's how it looks like, how to find variance in a nutshell, students.